In the last video, hopefully you saw a text lecture and loaded in all the data that was contained inside that lecture. So we are now working with a database that has a very different schema. We now have a table of users, a table of orders, and a table of products. This database is going to kind of simulate an e-commerce application, so a user can order a product. One thing that we're going to investigate is the relationship between users and products. You're going to learn that this is a many-to-many relationship. One user can have many products, and one product can have many users. We are modeling that relationship by using the orders table. We would refer to this table in this case as a join table. Now, enough of all that. I'm going to tell you a lot about many-to-many relationships in just a little bit. I just want to give you a very quick preview. For right now, let's investigate the structure of these tables a little bit more. So I would encourage you to maybe do a select star from users and take a look at some of the different properties and values inside of here. So it looks like users has ID, first name, and last name. We can do the same for about products. And we'll see that products has ID, name, a department, a price, and a weight. The weight presumably here is maybe the weight of the product in kilograms, and it's probably listed here for maybe shipping purposes or something like that. The price doesn't seem to have any units tied to it. We can imagine that maybe it is US dollars or something similar. In total, there are about 100 products inside of here. And then finally, we'll take a look at orders. An order represents a user attempting to order or purchase a product. So orders has an ID for the order itself. It has the ID of the user who is attempting to purchase a product, the ID of the product that the user is trying to purchase, and then finally, whether or not the user has paid for their order yet. So if a user has not paid, we would see false inside of here. And once a user has paid, we should see true. Okay, so three tables. We're going to take a look at some more topics and interesting ideas in the world of SQL in just a little bit. But first, let's do a little bit of a recap on some of the different topics we've learned in this course already. So we're going to run a couple of queries on these three tables over a couple of different exercises, just as a quick review on stuff like group by, selecting, joins, and so on. So quick pause right here, and let's take a look at our first exercise in just a moment.